And as we learn to have him speak to us so that we would understand what our day was designed for and how we should walk in a way that's pleasing to him and not just to ourselves. Enjoy what you are doing. And you shall eat before the Lord your God, and you shall rejoice in all to which you put your hand, you and your households in which the Lord your God has blessed you. I used to hate waiting in the airport, but Dave always wanted to arrive early. I finally changed my mind. It is amazing what happens when you decide to enjoy God every day. It is easy to get so caught up in all your responsibilities that you forget to enjoy what you're doing. You can get so busy raising your children that you forget to enjoy your children. You can get so caught up in cleaning your house, trying to pay for it, and remodeling it that you forget to enjoy it as it is. But you can learn to enjoy God so much that no matter what you do today, you can truly say, I enjoyed it. Personal satisfaction and enjoyment is simply a matter of choice. I learned a long time ago the way to be content was that, as Paul said, to learn in whatsoever state you're into there and be content, was that I personally got enjoyment out of little things that I made personal to me, that I would say, oh wow, this is just like a little thing between God and I. And then he would meet me there and fulfill them, like getting a glazed donut. It was like a once a week thing for me. Was I was so excited to get this one glazed donut, and to go along with it, I treated myself to a fountain Pepsi. And this was as an adult, because where I was at that time was so poor that when I paid my rent, I had nothing left over. I had very little for food. I had no car. I worked next door to where I lived, but once a week I could go over to the little strip mall, and I'd go get that one donut shop, I'd sit down, me and God, and I'd have my little 16-ounce Pepsi, might have been 32, and I'd eat my one donut, and I enjoyed it, and I loved it. And you know, I can tell you to this day that even when I was in casinos and ate filet mignon or whatever it is that they... No, not filet mignon. Oh, it might be filet mignon. Whatever steaks they offer. It wasn't quite so good as tasting that glazed donut and that Pepsi after waiting all week to get it. God can bless you where you're at. You can enjoy the day, or you can look at it as a toil and troublesome thing. But if you choose to delight yourself in the fact that he's with you there, you can make anything you're going through or anything you're living at the moment you're living it kind of fun. I know I did, whether it was in a hospital bed or whether it was in poverty or whether it was in success. The choice is yours. How are you going to participate in your day today? Are you going to make it a bummer? Are you going to rejoice in it? This is the day that the Lord has made. I, for me, will rejoice and be glad in it. I hope you make the same choice.